data from a DICOM file, which we can export to JPEG or to other image formats. If we use the correct spelling, we can test it on the CT image, which we will then be able to open with any image viewer. What we would like is to be able to open and interpret DICOM files within a Java program. We'll here create a test application which will be able to browse DICOM directories, read the DICOM tags, and display the pixel data of a DICOM image. We will use the PixelMed library, which is available as a Java archive file and which we can add as a dependency. First, let's quickly design the interface. We'll first make a simple image viewer, with a button for selecting the DICOM file, and a J label which we will use to display the image. We use a JFile chooser to create a pop-up window for browsing the file system. We can put a default folder so we don't have to navigate through the folders while testing. If we choose a file, we can see that we can retrieve its absolute path in the terminal. Now we want to open the file and display the image content. Let's create a new method to do that. We can use the source image object from PixelMed to open the file. We'll then need to convert this PixelMed image into an image object compatible with the Swing library, which we use for the interface. Finally, to be able to display the image in a JLabel, we have to create an image icon object. If we test the program, nothing happens because I forgot to call the new method. If we replace the system print with a call to the load and display method and test again, we can now see the image appearing in the interface. Let's now try to open a DICOM directory. The goal is to read the directory and display a tree with the patient, study, series and image hierarchy. If we click on an image, we want to display that image in the JLabel. JTree objects, like JList objects, use a model to display the information. can open a DICOM file with PixelMed using the DICOM InputStream class. From this stream, you can extract an attribute list which will contain all the tags and their values. You can then use the DICOM directory object which implements a tree model from Swing, and can therefore be used as a model for our G-tree. Let's try this by opening the DICOM-dir file. We can see that the default tree model is replaced by a tree structure corresponding to the DICOM information model, with the patient, study, series, and image. We can make things a bit cleaner by removing the default model so that nothing is displayed when we start the program. Next, we use the value changed event of the G-tree to get the selected element of the tree. We can use the DICOM directory record class from PixelMed to load the DICOM tags of that element as an attribute list. We can have a look at all the attributes by first retrieving the set of tags and printing them to the terminal. We print the group and element portions of the tag and then the value of the tag in the attribute list. We can test that at all levels of the DICOM directory. There are two tags that we need for our application. The tag that tells us at which level of the information model we are, to check if we have clicked on an image, and the tag that tells us what is the relative path to the DICOM file containing the pixel data. We can retrieve any specific tag from the attribute list. As we can see, the list of existing tags is huge. If we look at the group and element of the tag we are interested in, we can use the DICOM documentation to find out its name. The first tag that we need is the directory record type. We can check if the value of that tag is equal to image. Quickly test that it works by printing image into the terminal. Now, we just have to use the reference file ID tag to retrieve the path to the image. The path that we get is relative to the path of the DICOM dir. We need to refactor our code a bit so that we keep the path of the DICOM dir that we opened as an attribute to our class. In this way, we can build the full path on the disk to the reference file by putting together the path to the directory containing the DICOM-dir file and the relative path to the selected image file. We can then just call our load and display method to show the selected image in the interface. In the next video, we'll take a look at the communication part of the DICOM standard.